He is an entrepreneur and martial artist. Welcome to the stage, Matthew Boyer. Give it up for him one time. Here he comes, making his way, the number one speaker of the day. Let's get it. But now I'm a man,
way past 21. Thank you. Leadership is more than words. To be a leader, you have to see, you have to hear, and you have to care. So I'm going to take you on a little journey with me, one of my students, a story about leadership. We're not too far from here today, about 2 hours away in Orlando, Florida. Riley and I were present for the IKF World Classic Kickboxing Tournament. I'm sprinting down the hallway because her name had been called from the main room. Announcers had called her. It was time to get her. I had to go find her in a hallway full of close to 300 fighters. Find her. I run up. I'm in a panic. Riley, get your gear on. We gotta go. It's your time. Okay. Slowly latches her gear. Kind of a reoccurring thing with Riley. She does everything at her own pace. Get down. We work our way through the hallway. Eyes are watering. Fighting from the Thai oil, which is fighting over the smell of everybody's body odor, and honestly is blinding at these events. We get to the main room, and her and I walk in, and it kind of hits us. You can feel the tension hit her as the lights in the room are down, the ring is on the other side, people are fighting. Fighters are limping out past us injured, and we're getting ready to step into the ring. My mind goes completely different from hers, and I jump back 10 years to when our martial arts journey started together. But as I'm working through that, I stop at 7 months prior to that event, and kind of a special thing happened. See, we had started a kickboxing program at the school, and a lot of the children and teens had kind of jumped on board with it. And I noticed Riley was disconnected from the group. She wasn't participating in the kickboxing. She class every night, put her gear on, head out the door. So I kind of cornered her. I said, hey, I've noticed, you know, that you're not doing kickboxing. I think you'd be really, really good at this. She just kind of looked at me and said, really? I'm like, well, yeah, you've been black belt. You've been training for a long time. You'd be excellent. Would you think about coming to kickboxing with us? Maybe. She's very few of words. This was a huge moment. Riley had put on a ton of weight, become very disconnected from her classmates. I didn't know why. Jump back 7 months, back in Orlando. We're getting ready to step into the ring. She's now 60 pounds lighter. She's went through this amazing journey. And we're walking in the room, getting her gloves latched up. We're getting up to the main walkway. And we're waiting for them to announce her fight and for us to make that walk to the ring. I lean over and I whisper to her that no matter what happens, the hard part of the journey is over. She's lost the weight. She's won the battles. Now we just got to fight. And then no matter what happens, I'm down there on the side of that ring, right there with her, and I've got her. Fight starts. 30 seconds before the end of the third round, she wavers a little bit. They stop the fight. I'm up the steps, over the ropes, in the ring, pulling her helmet off. She spits her mouthpiece into my hand. And she goes, I just wish I could have finished the round. That was important to me. A few weeks later, coming pictures pop up on Facebook. There's Riley smiling in her dress, beautiful as can be, and I start crying like a child. I mean ugly crying. Not just a little tear. I mean my wife asked if I need some tissues and some bonbons, like bawling. You know, are you okay? See, I knew that Riley had never went to a school dance before because her confidence was too low. Her communication with her friends was too low. And I knew seeing her smile in that dress that what we had went through had completely changed her life. So I want to share something with you guys today. Every year at Christmas, instead of Christmas presents, one of the parents has the kids and the students all write me letters. And I got Riley's permission to share this with you guys today. I legitimately couldn't do anything without you, the school, or the people in the school. You have helped me in so many ways I could not even count. Boyer Academy is a real savior for some people, and I believe I was one of those people. I don't know exactly what I was saved from, I know for sure I would not be the person I am today without you. See, part of being a good leader is I was able to use my eyes to see how she disconnected and to see the weight gain. I was able to use my ears to hear her after that fight say, "I just wanted to finish." And I was able to use my heart to care enough about her to see this through and to follow that passion and that dream with her. And that means the world to me. So at the end of the day, it's important for us to remember that leadership is not just about shares, likes, and views. Real leaders lead with their heart. Thank you.